Another very important question will arise. What question will arise? Can executing court go behind the decree? When we say, can executing court go behind the decree? It means, can executing court say that this decree is not executable? Can executing court can refuse to execute it? Can executing court say that it wants to look into the written statement, look into the plaint, look into the judgment, or it is bound to execute the decree as it is? Yes, students, very, 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 very important this question. Very important question. Therefore, first of all, listen to me. I will dictate each and everything, because the question is very, very important question. Now, let us see. I will give you one example. Then we will see whether it can be executed or not. Maybe we can take the same example. It will be better, because you have understood. Now, X has filed a civil suit against Y for recovering rupees 10 lakh. Now, Y is a factory owner. Now, the court has passed a decree for recovering rupees 10 lakh. Now, Y has... Firstly, Y was working at Jalandhar. Now he has shifted to Chandigarh. Now the court has transferred this decree to Chandigarh. Now Chandigarh court has received the decree. Now this Y, he has presented his objections under section 49. That the 47, by virtue of order 21, rule 23, on receipt of notice that this decree is not executable, because this decree was passed by the court, civil court, which was having no jurisdiction. Now, general law, keep in mind that the general law is that executing court is bound to execute the decree as it is. It cannot say anything. It is a general law. It cannot ask the party to bring the judgment, to bring the written statement, to bring the plaint, because decree is containing only consisting of two or three pages. Whatever is written in that, the executing court at Chandigarh is bound to execute. Now, this is the general law, but there are exemptions, many exceptions. Under those exceptions, the executing court, it can refuse to execute. Now, let us see in this case, the executing court at Chandigarh is fully competent to refuse to execute this decree on the ground that this decree is not executable, because this decree has not been passed by the court which was having jurisdiction over the subject matter, because subject matter in this case was relating to the labor court. Now, this question had arisen before Honorable Supreme Court in various judgments. Yes. First point. Now let us see here. Honorable Supreme Court has discussed this point in these judgments. It was Jaipur Development Authority versus Radhisham, then Sundardas Authority. Then there was Hoshiarpur Central Cooperative, then Karan Singh versus Chaman. In all these authorities, Honorable Supreme Court has laid down that if the court which passed the decree was having no inherent jurisdiction, then that decree is not executable. Then the executing court can refuse to execute that. Now, this is an exception to general law. What is the general law? That executing court will have to execute the decree as it is. It cannot say anything about decree. But Honorable Supreme Court has laid down in all these authorities that if the civil code or any revenue code or any other code is having no inherent jurisdiction to deal with the subject, then that decree is a non-est. It will be void. It cannot be executed. It will carry no value in the eyes of law. Now let us see the second exception, that in second exception. Now, if the decree has been passed against dead person, then also the executing court may refuse to execute that, because once the decree was passed against dead person who was not in existence, how the court can pass a decree against such a person without hearing the defendant? It has passed the decree. Let me give some example with regard to this. Now, X filed a civil suit against Y for taking possession of 10 acres of land from Y. Now, Y had already expired before the filing of the suit. This suit was filed on 1st January 2009. But Y, he had expired on 1st January 2008, 1 year ago. Now, the court has issued summons. It has issued proclamation, but the person is dead. After issuing proclamation, the court passed a decree. Now, this decree will be nullity. It will be having no value in the eyes of law. Suppose when X has filed an application for execution, son of Y comes forward. Son of Y says that Y had died earlier to the filing of civil suit. How this decree can be executed? Now, this is another exception where the executing court can refuse to execute the decree. Now, this question had risen before Honorable Supreme Court in these two authorities, Vasudeva, Tanji Modi, and second Amar Chand's case. And Honorable Supreme Court has laid down that if a decree has been passed by the court against that person who was not in existence, who had already expired, that decree cannot be executed. What we are here discussing, that can executing court go behind the decree? Now here, if the executing court has come to know that the decree was passed against a dead person, it can refuse to execute. Or if it has come to know that the court which passed the decree, it was having no inherent power, then also the court is having that discretion, having power to refuse that. Let us see the third point. Yes. Now, if the decree is silent, then how we can say that executing God can still go behind the decree? When we say executing God can go behind the decree, it means executing God can look into the judgment, that what is the real picture, what was the real scenario, what was the real circumstances. Now, therefore, the executing God can go behind the decree in case decree is silent with regard to certain facts. Let us see here. Now, X has filed a civil suit against Y for taking possession of 1 acre land bearing Khasra number 108. And X filed execution application, and the court, it has passed an order that the possession of Khasra number 108 should be handed over to X. Now, when at the spot the revenue officers visited and they have looked into record and they have pointed out that there is no such Khasra number 108. There are only 108A, 108B, 108C. Now, when these acres of land are available at the spot, now here, court cannot say which one of them should be attached, which one of them should be handed over to X. Now, for that, the court will go behind the decree. How it will go behind the decree? It will ask the plaintiff to bring the judgment. If it is clear from the judgment, then it will attach any of them. If the judgment says that it is 108B, now if judgment is also not clear, then the executing court can go behind this decree by getting copy of plaint. And if from the plaint it is clear that a civil suit was filed with regard to this plot 108B, then also the court can pass an order that 108B acre should be handed over to X. Now, this is how we can say, when the decree is silent about some fact, then executing court can go behind the decree. Now, here this question had arisen before Privy Council in 1949. And Privy Council has laid down the law that whenever a decree is silent about any fact, then executing court may go behind that decree. Yes, students, now next point, which is another exception where the executing court can go behind decree. If the circumstances have changed after passing a decree, then also court may refuse to execute the decree. Let me give an example here. This A has filed a civil suit against B for taking the possession of 10 acres of land. And the court passed the decree in favor of A. Now, when this A filed execution application for taking the possession from B, then the government has acquired this land for the purpose of constructing road on that land. And it has published in the newspaper, and the land has already been taken by government. Now circumstances have changed where this decree cannot be executed. We cannot take back 10 acres of land from government because government has acquired this land according to the procedure of law. Now suppose instead of acquisition by the government, this land has been merged with the river by flow of water due to flood. Now, here also we will say, when there is no land, therefore we cannot execute this decree. Thus, if the circumstances have been changed, then also we can say that the executing court can refuse. Now, this question had arisen before Honorable Supreme Court in two authorities, which are on screen. And Honorable Supreme Court has laid down that no doubt executing court should not go behind the decree. But if the circumstances have changed after the passing of the decree, then the executing court must take into consideration those changes which have taken place. Therefore, executing court may refuse to execute that. Now, we have already discussed, while discussing execution part in CPC, that which court is executing court, which court can execute the decree. Now, it is the court which passed the decree, or it is the court to which a decree has been sent for execution. Now, that court which is executing the decree, it can refuse to execute in such circumstances also. Yes, Mr. Jaswat. This. Yes. Now, sometime meaning of the word. Let us see meaning of the word, how it can happen. If meaning of the word from the decree is not clear, let me say here. Now, X has filed a civil suit against Y for recovering possession of the house along with, now this word is important, along with the WARA, WARA. Now this decree has been passed. What is the, has been written that X is entitled to take the possession of this house along with the WARA. Now WARA word is not of English word. Now meaning of this is not clear, whether it is talking about one room on the house or it talks about some area around the house. If it is area, what is that area? Now decree does not, it is simply decree. In the decree it has been written that X is entitled to this house along with WARA. Now executing court, it is to execute. Now how it will interpret this word, how it will come to know what is the meaning of this WARA? For this purpose, the executing court can see the judgment, that what has been written in judgment. If it is clear, then the court can act accordingly. But if it is not clear, then it can still go to the plaint that what has been written in the plaint, because the plaintiff might have given the dimensions of that vada, what is the length, what is the breadth, etc. Now this is how the executing court can go behind the decree if the meaning of word is not clear. Let me give one more example here. Now A has filed a civil suit against B for obtaining all mods of B. Now here all mods, it is difficult to understand what is the meaning of that, because this B, he is a some artist and he is having some model and modeling tools also. Whether we are talking about that models or modeling tools, therefore it is not clear from the decree. In the decree simply it has been written that A is entitled to all mods. Now here also meaning of the word is not clear. When meaning of the word is not clear, the executing court can say that let us look into the judgment. Let us look into the plaint. That is why we say that the executing court can go behind the decree in certain circumstances. But general law is that executing court cannot go behind the decree. Now let us see next word. Yes, interpretation of the decree, that how this question can be there. Now I will give you one example here. Now this father was having 200 acres of land in which he was having half share, because his brother was having half share. Now this father was having four sons. After the death of father, four sons have become joint owner of the property left by this father. Now this S1 has filed a civil suit against S2, S3 and S4 for taking his specific share, 1/4 share. And the court passed a decree that S1, S2, S3 and S4, they are entitled to 1/4 share. 1/4 share in 200 acres of land. Now here, if we interpret this, it means S1 is entitled to 50 acres. Now in fact, father was entitled to only 100 acres of land. Now the court has simply written that S1 is entitled to 1/4 share of entire property. Now here when the court has written 1/4 share of entire property, then we are to interpret entire property is 200. But father was not having full ownership of that land. Therefore, whenever there is a question of interpretation, then also executing court can go behind the decree. Yes, student, this question is very, very important question. Sometime it may carry 40 marks. You have to write each and every point with each and every judgment also in order to make this clear. Now let us see the next point. performance by JD not possible. Now, sometimes it may happen that decree has been passed, but it is impossible for that defendant to implement that. Let us see how it can be. Now, A has filed a civil suit against B for specific performance of a contract in which B, who is owner of house number 10, and B has agreed to sell this house to A for rupees 20 lakh, and B has received earnest money of rupees 5 lakh. And they have fixed a date for executing the sale deed. But B failed to execute the sale deed. And the court passed the decree that B must execute the sale deed. Now, before filing this execution application by A in the court for getting the sale deed executed, now this property has been demolished due to earthquake. When the property has been demolished, then B cannot execute a sale deed. Now once a decree is there, but it is impossible to perform that decree by JD, in such circumstances, we will say that this executing court can go behind the decree. It can refuse to execute, because in such circumstances, who can be given direction to perform, to execute that decree? Yes, Mr. Jiswat, bring next. Yes, students, now this is another point. This is another exception. If in the decree description of the property is not given, then how the JD can be compelled to execute that? Let me give an example. Now, X has filed a civil suit against Y for recovering house number 18, and the court has passed a decree that X is entitled to house number 18. But when X filed execution application, now X has pointed out that he is entitled to house number 18 plus swimming pool which is attached to that house, and some other area where a tube well has been installed, and some other area which is vacant place surrounding this house. Now these three points have not been enunciated in the decree by the court. Now, in such circumstances, the executing court can go behind the decree. Yes, students, now we have discussed general law. What is general law? That executing court cannot go behind the decree. But these are the exceptions, where executing court may refuse to execute the decree. Executing court may go behind the decree. When we say may go behind the decree, it can look into judgment. It can look into the plaint. Otherwise, ordinarily, the execute, it is not the function of executing court to see the judgment, to see the plaint, but in these circumstances it can do so.